Good morning, Namaste. It's truly an honor for me to present the national instrument of India to you, the Saraswati Veena. I think one place where most of us have seen the Veena, of course, is in the hands of Goddess Saraswati. Why is Goddess Saraswati holding a Veena? Why not anything else? What is so special about this Veena? So my topic for today is the voice of Veena. The first ever Veena man made was made using a human skull as a resonator with a bamboo as the stem and nerve gut for the strings. Luckily, they changed the design and I'm playing on something that looks pretty today. Now, the Veena has undergone a journey, a big journey, from gut and skull to wood and fret. It has changed in size, sound, structure, and shape over several thousands of years. What came out finally is the result of what has been designed like a human body, with the head exactly like a human body, the vertebral column, the spinal cord, and the lower portion. We have 24 presacral vertebrae in the human body in our spinal cord. The Veena exactly has 24 frets. And it's a 7-stringed instrument. 4 main strings which symbolize the 4 Vedas: Rig Veda, Yajur Veda, Sama Veda, and Atharvana Veda. And 3 strings in the side which symbolize Ichcha Shakti, which is desire, Jnana Shakti, which is knowledge, Kriya Shakti, which is action. The playing ledge is made out of wax, honeybee's wax, and the frets are made out of brass. And while playing, we activate the fingertips of the left hand and right hand. So as you all know, the fingertips have nerve endings, and stimulating nerve endings is acupressure points. So which is why this is considered as a form of yoga, something that heals, something that stimulates your pituitary gland, increases your concentration and things like that, which is why probably Goddess Saraswati is holding the Veena. But fine, it looks like the human body, it's got all this mystical and esoteric significance. What more? Indian classical music is very different from different types of music because it has what is called as a gamaka. The word gamaka comes from the word gachati, which means to go. So if you see anything Indian, Indian food, Indian architecture, Indian jewelry, look at our homes. There is so much of embellishment, ornamentation in it. Indian music too has a lot of ornamentation of notes, which is why the gamaka, which means embellishment or ornamentation, characterizes Indian music. The other thing that is very special to Indian classical music is improvisation. We do have compositions of great composers of the past, like in Western music, but we don't play it looking at the notation. Like, I don't have scores of notation in front of me, I don't see it and play. One has to internalize it and recreate it. So I can add my own gamaka, my own embellishment, my own ornamentation to that piece of music. Retain the core, retain the spirit, but I can recreate it. So that freedom is there, which is why improvisation, or what we call as manodharma, is such an important aspect of Indian classical music. Now coming back to gamaka, What does it do? Let's take a very simple tune which all of us have heard so many times. So what does Gamaka do to this? This is what Gamaka does to it. Now, notes create scales. What creates ragas? So raga and thala are the most important parts of Indian classical music. What creates raga? These gamakas create raga. We have notes. Notes are like just you have your box of colors. But when you paint them, you give a curve, you give a wave, a meand, that's when it becomes a raga. I'll give you a small example of just by changing gamaka, how the raga changes. These notes are Rima Padani Da Pa Pa Mari Ga Ri Sa Ri. Now, this raga is called Naiki. It's a very feminine and gentle raga. Now, when I change the gamaka, I do. What was ni da pa? I changed it to ni ni da pa ga ga ri sa ri. That becomes darbar. So, just by changing the gamaka, an entire raga changes. Now, even within one raga, let's say I take a rag like Puriya Dhanashri, or what we call in the South as Kamavardhini. When I change the gamaka, the emotion or color changes. It's exactly like when I want to say, how did you come here? Let us take that sentence. How did you come here? When I say, how did you come here? I mean, what mode of transport did you take to come here? When I say, how did you come here? I mean, like, of all the people, how did you come? So, with the change of intonation, how the raga changes. You see, the same. This is one emotion, same notes. When I change the gamaka, the emotion change. What was? I do. So, once you change the gamaka, the emotion changes. Okay, what else is special? In Veena, which is called the mother of all instruments in India, this gamaka originated from the Veena. So, if you see a guitar, the frets are, the fretboard is flat. So, what I can do is. I can go to that fret, I can go to the note pa and play pa. I have to go to the note ni and play ni. But in Veena, you have an entire vertical world. So I can literally pull strings and play the entire phrase in one fret itself. For instance, are you able to see this? This is one phrase. I can do that in one fret. So, you can do like. So, Which is why now many instruments in the West, many guitarists are getting a fretboard with scalloped frets so that they can also pull strings like us. And the other beautiful thing is, though we call it a very mystical, very spiritual instrument, of course, like any other instrument, you can play any genre, you know, people are using it for film songs, for jazz, for rock, for bhajans, for anything, you know, folk, everything. Of course, you can do that with every other instrument. You can play any music on any instrument. The limitation is not in the instrument. If there's a limitation, it's in the player. So the instruments are all, you know, very, very complete and versatile. But why the veena? Because not only can you play these different genres, you can add those little filigree works because of the frets. You can add those special Indian touches. Let's take a jazz scale like... let's see. You can give that in the veena, that. Can do. Instrument like this, you are multitasking. How? You are doing a motor activity in your right hand. You're doing. This goes on your right hand. Left hand. Take off your. So you just do. Mm-hmm. you do all that with your left hand. You're thinking of the ragam, you're thinking of the talam, you're thinking of the lyrics, you're thinking of the grammar of the rhythmic cycle. Is it a rhythmic cycle of 8 counts or is it a rhythmic cycle of 6 counts? You're thinking of the left hand, what note can come, what gamaka can come. Am I sitting in the right posture? Am I communicating to my audience? So you're like thinking about 10 to 12 things, which is why at the same time you're giving pressure to your nerve endings. Which is why this is such a beautiful activity. At least it's a non-screen activity. So this is a very beautiful activity, which is why many ragas have said to have a healing effect. Playing an instrument itself is a beautiful healing effect on you. It increases your concentration, your bandwidth to retain more information. Now, Veena is an instrument, probably the only instrument that has both melody and rhythm and harmony built into the structure of the instrument. Melody, when you do, that's your melody. And rhythm, when the motor activity starts, the rhythm is there. And harmony. So, what is so beautiful about the Veena is what is called as a Thanam, where all this is interwoven. I'll play you a very, very brief outline of how a Thanam sounds on a Veena. We have a lot of other influences today, And we have embraced it. We have embraced so many things from the world, different instruments that have come into the fabric of Indian culture, Indian music. Yet, this instrument that has been here since the Vedic age or even before is now presented worldwide. I have had the pleasure of presenting it in most of the countries, right from the United States to Canada to Australia to Mauritius to almost all parts of Europe and Emirates and everywhere. It has been featured in the Kennedy Center, the Royal Albert Hall, the Royal Festival Hall, Queen Elizabeth Center, everywhere. And the world has embraced it as a symbol of India, a symbol of Indian culture. So I would conclude by saying, we should embrace Goddess Saraswati's own instrument, the voice of Veena, as the voice of India. Thank you so much.